Now I'm in.
If a drag queen falls in the forest and no one is around to hear it, does she slay? Hi. Welcome back. I'm Miss Avocado here at fun.com, here to talk to you about some wig stuff. Today what we're gonna be talking about is volume. We've brushed this girl out. And now she's looking good, but she could use a little bit more volume. So what we're gonna do today is some basic teasing. Nothing crazy. Plastic hair loves to tease, so it won't take too much effort. What you're gonna need for this is a little teasing brush like this. You can get them at Target, Sally Beauty, Walmart, whatever, for like $3. They have a nice little pick for separating sections right there. And in the front, we have nice bristles, which are perfect for teasing. I have a couple other teasing brushes. This is a teasing brush. This is a teasing brush. As long as they have these nice bushy bristles, they will tease just fine. So what we're gonna do is, she's looking pretty good, but she could use a little bit of volume specifically right here, like all up in the crown. So how we're gonna do that, we're going to take the end of our little brush. We are going to take a tiny section. Some of these wigs might have what's called perma-teasing in them. That's factory teasing that was added on conception of the wig. We're going to tease around that, add a little bit extra volume, because we're those girls at the party. What you're going to do is hold a section of hair taut, and then you're going to take your little teasing brush. You are going to basically wipe from the middle all the way down, whoop, to the crown. And you're gonna do this kind of in a little fast sweeping motion, kind of like this. Once you've done that, like once or twice, you're gonna pull all the way out, whoop. Basically what we're doing, whoop, pull all the way out, down, 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 all the way out, down, 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 all the way out, down, 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 all the way out, down, 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 all the way out, down, 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 all the way out. We're basically making a big bubble of knots in the hair. Once again, plastic loves to just tangle. So we're not gonna have to try too hard to get it to tease. After that, I just take our little wig lock that we just teased, and I like to brush out the ends gently with our brush so that we can keep our ends neat. Because we're trying to add volume, we're not trying to make a mess of the wig. And we are tangling it, so that might make a little bit of a mess. But just look at how much volume we've got so far. That's just hanging off the head right there. So we're gonna try to make the other bits match. One thing that you can do if your teasing is a little bit above the head, because it's kind of just like a sad rabbit ear, we're going to take our little pick end and we're going to just push some of that down towards the roots. Because ultimately, ideally, all of our teasing should be at the roots. And then it's kind of laying a little bit flatter. So we're gonna take another section right next to it. And I'm just kind of like using my finger as a hook and just whoop, grabbing a little section about as wide as this brush, honestly. Work in smaller sections, they're easier to tease. If I just grab a whole wad of hair and tease a bunch of it, then A, it's not gonna tease very well. B, like you're gonna get like all kinds of knots that you don't want in the hair in random places. If we have a smaller section, we can just control where all our teasing is going a lot better. So, small sections. And also, how are you gonna brush the ends out at the end if you've got so many knots in it? Right. So there's another little bubble of teasing. She's kind of turning away from you, but that's what we're working with. Ba-bang! And if it looks a little crazy as we're going, and it will, don't worry about that, because we're going to do another process after we tease called smoothing. So here I go. I'm just going to keep teasing up the full crown and get right back to you. As you're doing this, make sure you're always holding it nice and upward, because that's where we want the volume to go. Whichever way you're holding the hair as you tease it is which way the volume is gonna wanna, the teasing is going to wanna stay. So the hair will be holding out like this if we teased it that way. The hair will be holding much higher if we tease it straight up, so. Not that holding it out or anything is bad. It's just for different purposes. This girl, she wants to go. I'm kind of taking the top of the brush and just kind of very lightly skimming across the top. Not digging in at all, just making it smoother. Okay. Kind of got some volume all the way around, as you can see right there. What I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna smooth down the top because we've got a nice amount of volume now. But as you can see, kind of, maybe you can see from there, we've got a lot of knots just kind of sticking out, hanging out. We don't want those there. Unless you do. Unless you're being like the Little Mermaid who fell in the garbage can as your cosplay, which is valid and kind of iconic, but we're not doing that right now. So we're smoothing out our knots. See how I'm kind of like diagonally making contact with the hair? I'm not digging in. I'm not digging in very deeply. I'm just taking the hair brush and putting it sideways and just dragging it across the top. Just evens out those nice little top hairs. Whoop. Sometimes those knots are going to especially not want to go. That's when we use our brush straight down and just kind of pull straight out, so that we preserve our volume while getting rid of the knots. Okay. She's becoming something. Not gonna lie to y'all, I did not go into this with a vision, so she's just kind of telling me what she wants right now. And for the most part, if you go into a wig with styling without any plan, it'll tell you how it wants to lay. They have all these extra little curls already in them. They've been cut a certain way or something like that. They'll tell you where they want to go. So it's that part of the episode where I'm going to now use a tool that I forgot to mention earlier. You're going to want to pick like this. It's got that diagonal shape or like this, the straight shape. All they're really necessary for is pulling the teasing where you want it to go. So you can kind of see, if you look at her straight on, she's got kind of some places where we'd like a little bit more volume. All our teasing that we've just put in is gonna help us shape her how exactly we want her. So I'm just putting the pick in and pulling in a direction that I want her to go, kind of smoothing her over afterwards. Sometimes you might have to get in there with your hands. And this will also counter any volume lost by our little smoothing process. Boink, boink. And wow. At this point, she's kind of giving us go-go dancer, like 60s mod go-go dancer. So I think that's where we're gonna keep her. For the rest of the teasing, I think maybe the bangs would be another place that we wanna go. So, I'm going to take our bangs. They're already laying kind of nicely. So, we're gonna take a little small section of our bang. We're going to lift it upwards and tease right in this little corner pocket, because that's where it's gonna be able to hide so we don't see it on the top of the head as much. So, here we go. Pushing it down, pushing it away. Push it down, push it away. And gather our whole section up, neaten out our ends. Ooh, I like how much bigger that got. Okay, so I'm gonna take the rest of the bangs, tease underneath them. Will this feel prickly against your face? Yes, but that's kind of the wonderfulness of wigs. You never forget you're wearing them. I'm kidding, if you've got a wig and you're feeling good, usually when the look is together, you feel good. Just neatening out these ends again, and then we're gonna marry it to our other bang section by neatening the ends together, kind of brush them together a little bit. Ooh, look at this volume. All right, good volume comes from very, very thorough teasing, which is kind of what we're giving her today. This one I'm going to tease from behind. Let me just turn it back. Same way that I was doing the other ones, kind of, actually. So like here, teasing into the pocket where we won't be able to see all of that nasty knotting. And then marry it into the sections by brushing our ends together. So let's look at it from the front. Or I'm looking at it from the front. It's a secret to you. You don't get to see it. No, I'll turn it around in 1 second. So, you see how much extra volume we've got? My God. Say that you were doing some kind of 70s disco look. This would be perfect for that. Perhaps a drag Ariel, Little Mermaid kind of thing. All that's really left to do now is just kind of shape the bang to where we want it. Because of all this teasing in here, we can basically just play with this now and just make her lay exactly how we want to. And I'm just kind of shaping it how I want it. She always wanted to have a little cute wave away from the face, 70s middle part. So we're just gonna let her do that. Oh, all right. Now just look at the difference between those sides. We got womp womp, and now we've got va va voom. So we're gonna do what we did to the other side on this side, and it's gonna look nice and voluminous in the front. I think the official title that I'm gonna go with for this wig is Disco Ariel. We're in the era of reinterpreting Disney princesses, so let's give her a decade that we love. Taking another small section towards the front of the head, brushing right into that crevice. Brushing our ends out, keeping them untangled, just the ends. You can leave all the tangles at the base, that's where we want them. So here's a little preview of the full thing. See how she's just ba-bam now? That is my favorite part of wig styling, is just making things look ridiculous. If you want it to look less ridiculous, all you have to do is tease it just a little bit less. That's basically the same process we were doing, but with a little bit more smoothing. So we just wanna, if you wanted to make her a little bit smaller, you could push it down. The teasing will listen to you. Keeping my hand pinched right here because that's where we want it to arch. Just kind of, this time I'm digging into the hair, kind of like this, so that I can actually catch some of these hairs and pull them out. As long as you've teased it gently, they should want to cooperate. If you teased it too hard, which is very possible because teasing is kind of a rough process, then don't fret, just keep smoothing. She'll go the way you want to eventually, but it may be a lengthy process. I really like where she ended up, actually. This little middle part is really, really cute, and so I'm gonna keep that. What we're gonna do now that we've teased the whole thing, we've added a little volume to the crown. If you want it to be like really, really big, then you can go through section by section and tease the entire thing down to the bottom of the wig. We didn't do that today, because we didn't want to. All right. Well, I like where she's ended up, which usually means that we've teased her enough. So she's kind of come out a disco Ariel, so you can shake her around, dance into the night. What we would do now is start the styling process with some hairspray, but that's another video. So until next time, I'm Miss Avocado, and this is fun.com. Talk to you later, bye.